In this video, we are talking about ENCA interview with the Satanic Church leader in South Africa.
Africa has its first Satanic Church. Satanists now have an official place of worship in Cape Town.
What's up, guys? It's Ricky. This is a reality show. We do daily Christian commentary videos. Oh my goodness, that was a hectic video. Okay, the first video that I shot about Nephilim spirits and stuff like that, go watch that video. I'm telling you that video, if it's 3 minutes or it's 5 minutes, trust me, it took me 40 minutes to shoot that video, because I shot the first one, I scrapped it, I shot the second one, and then it was like I just went into like 20 minutes straight of me just sitting and talking. This is something that he had to say, which I thought was very, very interesting.
Just very quick last question: how are you going to stop people with bad criminal intentions from piggybacking on the back of, you know, your Satanic Church in your name?
Yeah, so two things. We have been in contact with the South African Police Service, and so far we are negotiating that should any such crime be reported, or called what they used to call it, occult crime, that we would be advised and asked about this. And then also we've appointed independent investigators to perform what we call forensic testing and polygraph tests. We have a church council that has put funds behind this to actually see whether the person involved was indeed involved in Satanism or rather devil worship.
Be out there giving advice to the SAPS. If anything that looks a bit satanic comes up, they might be giving advice to say what. Now, if you haven't seen my first video on that subject, I made a video. It's on the channel. If you just type Church Reality Check up at the top, Satanic Church, the video will come up, or you can actually, I'll try and remember and put it down in the description down below. Videos in the pinned comments are videos that I made today. And so there is something about this idea of giving advice that I thought. There was a subject that was going on early this year about Lobola, and it was very, very heavy. It was very, very big on the subject of giving advice. Bear in mind, there was a lady who was also featured in a lot of interviews. This is not me. This is her. So don't come here asking me questions. I didn't say go out there and claim yourself to be otherwise. This lady was anti-Lobola. She was anti. She hates the idea of Lobola. By the way, Lobola is very biblical. It goes all the way into the Old Testament. That's a subject of another day. But even the church, the idea of the church, it's a context. It's put in the context of marriage. The idea of redemption is put in a sense of Lobola. And so when a Christian is against it, I'm very suspicious of you. When she went popular, she was all over the place online, what. And come to find that lady who was opposing, you know, remember this idea of giving advice, that lady is a member of this satanic thing. They've already started giving advice before you. If you go on that lady's Facebook page, you will find, it's not even, I'm showing you pictures on her Facebook page where she's showing herself with devil horns. Her profile picture at one point was the Baphomet. The Baphomet is the goat. So that lady, I found it very funny that he mentions they're going to be out there giving advice. And for me to have heard that lady saying that she's also out there giving advice to people that are on about marriage and Lobola and the whole nine yards, I found it very funny. And so they've already started giving advice. You want to be careful what advice you are hearing. Least you are hearing the advice from the devil. Hope I got every video that I wanted to make today done. Those videos which are done today, they'll be down in the pinned comments. The video on Satanism that I did last time will be down in the description down below. Be careful what advice you end up hearing, because I've already shown that they are already contradicting some of the statements that the church really stands for. Better get yourself ready. It's about to get hectic out here. These people are out here, they are campaigning, they are pushing themselves out there. It's Ricky, and I'll see you later on. You know, we're no longer opposed in these days. Just go and do whatever you want to do. The Bible has already told us that the spirit of disobedience, yeah, it's their time to come out now. The Bible says, he that is filthy, let him be filthy still. He that is dirty, let him be dirty still. He that is, you continue your false spirits. Ricky, and I'll see you later on. We knew you were coming. It's only your time. You just continue. The Bible has already told us about people like y'all. Do as you may. Salute.